Mike Harcourt, of course, is willingly giving up the job of mayor to become a backbencher in the NDP opposition after October 22. And I want to ask you very bluntly, Mr. Harcourt, off the top, as an old chauvinist, it's easier to be rough with you than it is with Grace McCarthy. Do you think Skelly's doing any kind of a job at all? Or is he bound to fall on his face more on this election campaign?
No, I think that Bob Skelly has done an excellent job, Jack, over the last 2 years of reorganizing the NDP, setting up the policies for this election
campaign. But as a campaigner, we were all appalled by his hesitancy on opening night when he lost the place altogether.
Yeah, I think that's a minor issue. I think that Bob, the success of Bob Skelly is in the candidates that he's attracted to run for the NDP. They're the finest team we've ever had. People like Dave Vickers over in Victoria, the ex-deputy attorney general, Darlene Missouri, and
a lot of
good candidates.
I hope to have some of them.
The policies are very attractive policies with the public. At least we stand for something. We stand for what we would like to see happen in British Columbia, and that's a little difference than the tap dance that we're getting so far from the Social Credit Party.
Mind you, you stood for a lot of things too, because I remember you being totally against Expo, sending telegrams and wires to people saying, we don't want Expo.
Unless.
You were not keen on BC Stadium. You dragged your feet on the Canby Street Bridge, and you got to give Social Credit credit. The Expo 86 has been a fabulous success. The bridge is wonderful. And the stadium, I'm not so sure of.
Well, you're only about 100% off target, Jack. That's not like you. Usually only 10% off target.
Just a moment. Are you telling me you did not oppose Expo 86?
I'm saying that I said to the Expo people and the provincial government who were trying to convince us that it would cost $75 million. Remember those days?
I remember $75 million.
Right. And I said it's going to cost $1 billion, and I want the city off the promissory note. That was condition one.
And you got that.
Right.
But just for the sake of the
record. I think this is important.
No, I'll tell you why.
I fought three election campaigns on those issues. And have won increasing margins from the public of Vancouver for the tough stand I took to prevent a Montreal Olympic debt in our city and to prevent the schmozzle of Expo 67, which was a success and 20 years later as an eyesore. I fought a tough battle for the interests of our citizens, and I make no apologies, and we came out the other side smelling like a rose. As a matter of fact, on the Canby Street Bridge, it was my initiative that got that thing to the public and built. So I don't know where you got the impression that I dragged my heels on it.
I remember you dragging the heels.
No,
on
I was the one that pushed
until
it.
You got your fair of the cut, you dragged your heels
no,
on it.
No, I had to get it up to the public to get approval to build it. It took me a while to get the council to agree to put it up before the public, but that was my project, Jack. I think
anyway,
you got that one.
You're all in
wrong.
Favor of Expo now anyway, because you got the right deal the city wanted.
We got a good deal for the city, and we're using Expo as a way of pushing off into the economy in our second century.
Give you full credit for that. Yeah. What about BC Place after Expo? Is it going to be a disaster?
No. We have approved a rezoning for a large part of the site to be recycled for housing, for offices, for hotels, for marinas, for parks, for public facilities. And Stanley Kwok, I want to give him his due, has done a magnificent job as the president of BC Place of developing a very attractive project that will start January the 1st.
Good. Now,
and
let's go.
Unanimous agreement of council that will happen.
Let's go to some of the NDP promises.
Yeah.
End the Compensation Stabilization Board and lift restraint on civil servants.
Well, basically, that's saying we need to have collective bargaining back in this province and that the restraint will be the ability to pay. What we have had in this province over the last little while is a disastrous program of savaging our provincial economy, labor management relations, the education system, social services, and that's, Jack, one of the major issues in this campaign is that the BC public were misled in the last election. They did not vote for the restraint program that Social Credit brought down on us that Bill Vander Zelm was part of.
Well, you had Grace McCarthy say the recession is behind us. Do you believe the recession is
behind
us now?
The recession is still there outside of the Lower Mainland. The recession is savage up in the various natural resource-based areas of the province, and a large part of it was caused because of the depression atmosphere that was created in this province by the restraint package that that Bill Vander Zelm and Grace McCarthy were a part of. As a matter of fact, if you look at the Social Credit Leadership Convention results and you look at the announcement by, and I think this is one of the most telling remarks that were made by the nominator of Grace McCarthy, who was the alderman out in Surrey, Rita Johnson, who said, and we're proud that Bill Vander Zelm was the person we sent in to go after the education system as our first target for restraint.
Do you think Bill van der Zandt, he's obviously going to walk away in the election. You've got to concede that.
I don't concede that at all.
Do you think he's doing, if he makes it, will he be a good premier?
I don't concede that at all,
You don't
Jack.
Concede it?
I don't concede that at all. And I think the media has been remiss so far in this election campaign in the 60 days when they refused to look at this man's track record, which is appalling. His 10-year track record.
How appalling.
He was the minister of human misery for too many years when he picked on the poor and the disenfranchised in our society. He then left the wreckage there and took over the education system and became the minister of miseducation, started the demoralization, the disintegration of
cutting
the education system.
Orders.
Cutting out the English as a second language and the other important programs in Vancouver. Thirdly, he then shifted after leaving a wreckage there to be the Minister of Municipal Affairs and centralized power and wanted to have such draconian controls over local government that even people like Bob McClellan that eliminated the Human Rights Act and the Human Rights Commission said it was going too far, and he called his colleagues gutless. I mean, that's the record of this man, and that has not been pointed out, and the media...
Van der Zandt called his colleagues weak and gutless when he quit over that
that's
crisis.
Right, they didn't go far enough. And I think
but
that...
But maybe
that,
what we need is a strong one-man government in Victoria, a guy full of confidence and smiling who will get things done.
You know what we need? We need more than somebody that's going to do a tap dance through the tulips in this province. We need somebody that's going to act like a premier. And you know what a premier does? A premier says, here's our program for helping British Columbia after Expo.
Well, now
and
this
we are not getting anything except research. Have you read this?
Well,
this
I read
new
it,
economy for
I
British Columbia,
gave,
Jack?
Gave Gracie's pitch that this will be 500,000 jobs in the next 24 years.
There is nothing new. This is recycled press releases. There are four items here. One is our airport, which has grown from 4 to 23 international carriers over the last 5 years. There's more coming. That's going to happen anyways. There's nothing new there. They say we're going to place BC representatives and embassies into the Pacific Rim. Well, we're only 5 to 10 years behind. Quebec, Ontario, and Alberta already have their own offices, so we're going to place somebody in a back closet after the markets there have opened up. The special enterprise zones they're talking about, our council has
maybe
unanimously rejected.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the fourth thing, an international financial center is already on the books, is being developed federally by Stanley Hart, the Deputy Minister of Finance, with the assistance of the city. We're on the task force there. There is nothing for the economy. There is no new economy. You know what there is? There's recycled PAP. That's what this document is.
Recycled PAP from Bill van der Zandt, who will become what caliber of premier?
Well, I don't think that... Bill van der Zandt can be a premier if he is saying to the public, elect me because I'm a good singer and I can tap dance. He is not going to be the kind of leadership we need in this province. So I don't have a great deal of confidence, but it's not because of Bill van der Zandt. Very pleasant fellow, he smiles, but he's not showing any leadership.
It's because they've got no economic strategy.
There is no tough, well thought out game plan for the provincial economy, as the NDP has put forward. The New Democrats have put forward a very good, comprehensive cooperative program for recovery in the province.
Okay, Mayor Mike Harcourt, we're going to take calls to Mike Harcourt now, after the break. In November 1984, you slaughtered van der Zandt when he ran for mayor of Vancouver. But he's obviously going to slaughter Skelly in October 86, isn't he?
Well, I'm of the KC Stingle and the Yogi Berra school of politics. It ain't over till it's over.
Okay. Did he debate you during that period?
22 different times, Jack. I debated him 22 different times. And I think it's ridiculous. It is, I don't know what this man's trying to hide.
He won't debate Skelly.
I don't know what he's
he?
Trying to hide. Well, the same reason that I debated him. Because that's what democracy is all about, and that's what leadership is all about, is going out, laying it on the line, telling people what you stand
for. So he's
for.
Gutless.
I think it's a lack of courage and a lack of leadership on his part. If I can debate him as the incumbent mayor, a very popular mayor, elected by a large majority of the time before, 22 different times in one city, sure as heck he can debate Bob Skelly at least once in 147 municipalities throughout this province. I think the man is, that's a very serious error on his part.
You to think refuse the man is to, what?
I think it's a very serious error
lack
on his
courage.
Part. I think it's a lack of courage and a lack of leadership.
But it might be good tactics, although Skelly wouldn't seem to be any threat to him.
Listen, it would have been good tactics for me not to debate the guy. He was a temporary visitor from I don't know where. I can't keep tracks of him.
Fantasy Gardens.
Well, wherever. And I agreed that as a temporary visitor, we'd sit down and show him something about the city of Vancouver.
And you whipped him 22 times. Gosh, what if you get beaten in center? And what are you running?
I'm working hard. Emery Barnes and I are running a Vancouver center, and we're working hard. We've got a good campaign committee.
Go ahead, please.
Yes, good evening. I would like to ask Mr. Harcourt what is going to happen to our Sunday liquor laws after Expo.
The Sunday liquor laws, I'm not sure that it was anything other than a temporary addition to British Columbia during the Expo period, sir. So I don't think it's something that, except in a few limited areas.
Hey,
so
it's not like life. If you can't drink on Sunday, I don't care about them anyway.
But you can drink on Sunday. They just want wide open drinking in pubs and everything else.
Yeah, wide open gambling.
Do you know how many places? Well, listen, that's a dangerous one. The gambling is something that
I've been through that with
bad one.
Gambling means mafia, pimps, and everything. Yeah. Go ahead, please.
Yes, I tried to get on with Drake McCarthy, but I'm glad I'm on with an NDPer. I was just inquiring about the $10 tax levy on the. For the rapid transit.
Well, it's that's down. That's gone, ma'am.
That's gone, eh?
Yes, it's down. It's back down to what it was before of $1.60. That was initiated, by the way, by the Greater Vancouver Transit Commission. And there's a good example, Jack, of where it's the same old gang.
Yeah,
there's the same old gang where instead of letting the Regional Transit Commission go ahead and make the announcement that we've listened to the public.
Of taking it off.
It's the setup, the rotten setup we have for transit. They come in, and Rita Johnson, the new minister, preempts the Regional Transit Commission decision to do that and says, we, the province, are going to do it. It's an example of why we just got more of the same
And the Regional Transit Committee had already decided
We'd
to
We'd already instructed our staff to take it off, and they came in and said, we've asked them to do it, and we're glad that we did it.
Go ahead,
It's the
please.
Same old gang, Jack.
Go ahead,
unfortunate.
Please.
I'm Mr. Harcourt.
Yes, hello, sir.
I have two questions for you. First one is, how are you going to react to being a backbencher MLA after having the authority in the city of Vancouver for as long as you've had? And secondly, how soon after Mr. Skelly falls flat in his face after this election are you going to seek the leadership of the NDP?
Well, as I said, I'm from the Yoga Berra School of Politics. It ain't over till it's over, and the only poll that I'm interested in is the one that's taken October the 22nd by the voters.
And you're no Keith Davey either, are you?
That's right. Mm. I'm not a rainmaker. I'm into being an optimist and into sunny times for this province with a new government come October the 22nd.
But you know that's what everybody's
saying. I'm bringing some real...
I mean, I didn't ask you that question because you wouldn't answer it, but you know what everybody's saying. If Skelly gets beaten this time, they'll have to get rid of him quickly so you can take over for the next election.
Well, I think Bob Skelly's doing a good job.
Well, that's, you know, that's a good political answer. Go ahead, please.
Yes, good afternoon, Jack. I'd like to ask Mr. Harcourt a question. Regarding his recent trip to China, he said the day before his trip that we in Vancouver have a rotten transit system, and then the next day he goes to China to sell that system. I'd just like to frame and explain that to get the logic of that.
Well, I didn't go to China, sir. I was in Bangkok. So
you've
got the wrong country.
A rotten transit system.
Yeah. And the transit system that, I said that we have a transit authority that has three or four different groups running. I didn't say the transit system. The transit system, the ALRT system, is not the one I would have chosen for Vancouver. I would have chosen a conventional system, and that's very clear.
I saw the press conference you were announcing at, and that's exactly what you said. We had a rotten transit system. And then you turn around and go to Asia and try and sell it.
I don't understand your point, sir. I said that we have a rotten transit authority set up. The transit system that we are looking at in Bangkok is not determined. It's going to be different than this system here. It's going to be substantially different.
What are you looking at a transit system in Bangkok for anyway?
Because it's Canadian technology we're trying to sell. We're trying to sell... the cars, the technology.
Was this a junket?
Yeah, it was a sales trip, Jack.
For Canada?
Sales trip for Canada and for British Columbia. We had, for example...
No, enough of that. I believe
I think
that.
It's important.
No,
I mean,
you're going forever.
People that say that you're wasting your time, you don't sell by sitting on your butt. You sell by getting out to your markets and going with your business community to help open doors.
Fair
and
enough.
We were very successful.
Go ahead, please.
Hello, Jack.
Yeah.
Good evening. Mr. Harcourt.
Yes, sir.
I would like to say that the 2 terms I believe you've been in as mayor, I'm quite ecstatic about the work you've done for our city.
Thank you.
And second of all, I would also like to see you maybe become leader of the NDP party and give BC something to start striving for, and I believe in everything you say.
Thank you.
Well, I'd like to be part of a Bob Skelly New Democrat government. That's my...
That's your line. Go ahead, please.
That's my line. That's what I like to see happen, Jack.
Go ahead, please. And of course, I believe it. I didn't mean that snarky smile that you were disloyal to Skelly or anything, because I know you're not. Go ahead, please.
Yeah, I'd like to bring up an issue that was definitely a sticky wicket in the last campaign, and that's with regards to the public service.
Right.
I'm a public servant, and as you're no doubt aware, we just agreed to a 5% increase over the next 33 months or so.
Right.
And in hearkening back to 83, you know, the Socreds were sold then as being conciliators and having a moderate approach, and then, of course, after the campaign, they brought down the axe
on the civil
service.
Yeah.
As far as I'm concerned, you know, they talk about their style and sizzle, but when you open the oven, you can't smell a steak, or rather, I smell a rat. And I tend to think that if the Socreds are elected again, we're going to see even more severe restraint imposed.
Well,
thank you, sir.
I think there's two issues there, sir, and they're good points you brought up. Number one, are the public of BC going to be fooled again? They were fooled in 1983. We now have a person that is running for premier and is saying, I'm going to campaign on nothing. The NDP is campaigning for something. We're saying, here's what needs to happen in British Columbia in terms of creating jobs for our young people, in terms of reforestation, in terms of women's issues. We've got a good program for British Columbia. What we have, Jack, is a fellow here. It's not a question of style versus substance. It's a question of something versus nothing. The NDP stands for something.
And
the premier is saying, let me tap dance and smile for 28 days. And then trust me, come October the 23rd, I don't think the people of British Columbia are going to be fooled for a second time.
Mike Harcourt, the candidate in Vancouver Centre for the NDP. Thank you, Your Worship. I'll be back after the break.
Good to be here, Jack.